Welcome back to the Artie Lang Show. The great Daryl Hammond is here. Sing Your Face Off, May 31st on ABC. Check that out. He's a judge of an impression contest. Celebrities. Hilarious. John Ovitz.
John Lovitz.
Yeah. The great John Lovitz. And, of course, it's Caroline's April 10th through the 12th.
Is that this weekend?
That is.
It's coming right up.
Get ready, buddy.
Yeah.
But, okay, so Al Sharpton.
Oh, yeah.
Supposedly a rat for the feds. To take down some key members of the mob years ago. There was a great, great picture 2 days ago on the cover of the Daily News of the old Al, the Sharpton I know, the Tawana Brawley Sharpton with the processed hair, heavy set.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, so funny, so great.
I mean, he says he's the most interesting dude. He never, I always feel like he says what he actually thinks, which
rare.
He says things other people. I was watching TV once and I saw Dick Hepphart talking about Homeland Security and a change of channel. It's like Joe Lieberman talking about taxes. And I turned on Hannity and I heard Sharpton say, I did not call Giuliana Bozo. I said, Bozo could have done just as good a job, Giuliana. Clearly, that's that kind of Giuliana Bozo. That's what I said, Giuliana is Bozo. There's a world of difference. I'm like, wow, you're such an interesting man.
Officially the best impression of all time.
I tell you, Republicans are like Eve in the Garden of Eden when she laid eyes on Adam. She was not thrilled with her only choice. he says interesting stuff.
Oh, yeah. He's fantastic.
Yeah.
Now, you doing him is fantastic. What is it? But he did. He gained himself saying stuff like that and looking the way he did in the 80s. He gained enough credibility to where people apologized to him. Like white people, when they screw up, apologize to Al Sharpton. How did he gain that credibility? Like,
how does that
happen? He's saying what you just said. How does that happen?
He didn't actually say what I just said.
But well, he said the Bozo thing.
The Bozo thing he did say.
He said the Bozo thing.
Yeah.
And look, he's making a point. There is, I guess, a difference in calling him a Bozo thing.
I think Kyle Giuliano. Yeah. I mean, like, yeah. I like doing evangelists. I think they're, you know, I'm a kind of a dull person in real life, so it's funny to see people, you know, sermonizing, you know.
Mm-hmm. Oh God!
Like Jesse Jackson,
very
like,
charismatic.
Like if I used to do this bit about Jesse, like if you know, because he's so passionate. Like if you were like having dinner with him or something,
yeah.
You know, you're like Jesse. Do you think he'd like some dinner? He'd be like, I sell him a set that apple rattle some malsham. It made good judgment, but not only that. That's something that makes good sense.
That's how he spoke, and he wanted to be president.
Yeah.
Yeah, he wrote the run-on sentences.
Yeah. He was an interesting guy.
Yeah.
Yes, Caroline's. Yeah.
Will you be doing that brand of comedy there?
I will.
Well, Sharpton's in the news. You could do
Wilder, Sharpton, and...
Yeah, Sharpton is fantastic.
Well, Connery is the sort of the... Best, most popular thing I ever did was Sean Connery.
Yeah, now, you say you go to these college speeches, and they still just want you to do
that's
Sean
the
Connery.
Deal, yeah.
From the Jeopardy. You and Norman's Burr Reynolds, you and Sean Connery, that is like the...
I mean, you
and
know...
Will Ferrell's Alex
And
Trebek.
Will doing Alex, yeah.
It wasn't even... I mean, I can remember when we first thought of it, you know, because it doesn't make any sense that Sean Connery hates Trebek, or that he's not smart. But now
the
you're
joke
already,
is just he's like...
But you're already laughing. Yeah.
Right, well, the joke is just Connery's just... The mannest of men, and he just calls Trebek a wuss, right?
You know? I mean, I was sitting in my office one night, and I was, like, doing lines from, like, The Untouchables, you know, like, I'm not proposing marriage, you know? You don't have to think about it, just nod, you know? And then Will's there, and I said to him, not a fan of the... And this makes no sense.
Yeah.
Not a fan of the ladies, are you, Trebek? It's like, oh, wait. Now I have my niche in history.
Not a fan of the lady.
I mean, that doesn't make any sense.
You're calling Alex Trebek gay, is what you're doing.
It doesn't make. I mean, clearly he.
And it doesn't. He seems like a Lothario. He seems like the direct opposite is true.
I mean, I was walking down. I was thinking I was in Chinatown. I forget where I was. Maybe San Francisco, and looking for a Chinese restaurant or something. And the chef said to me, "Yeah, you're Trebek. You stupid." Come on. Even you too. You know, et tu, chef.
Well, he's a fan. The guy was a fan.
Yeah, I mean,
did you say et tu, chef?
Et tu, chef. I mean, you too. I mean, in Chinatown, also, you guys watched. I mean,
in San Francisco, the first
I never, like, did anything that crossed every cultural barrier.
Yeah.
Except, you know,
Sean,
like,
Connery. Yeah. I mean, that became a hugely popular sketch.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I feel like on my tombstone, it's not going to say, here's Daryl Hammond, he's a good dad. It's going to be, shuck it, Trebek. Shuck it long and shuck it hard. All right, see, you're laughing at that.
Yeah. Well, also, too, I'm thinking of Will's reaction, like, when he comes to the final Jeopardy, he's looking at your answers. He goes, it says nothing. Apparently, you don't know how to play the game.
Oh, sticks and stones may break my bones, but I tapped your mammy. Really?
I don't even know what that means.
I have no idea what
that means. Yeah. All right. Yeah. Yeah, Will just. And then there's only some guest host who's not as good as any of you guys who's trying desperately to keep up.
Some of them were pretty terrific.
Yeah.
I mean, I thought Tom
Cruise.
Do you
have any favorite ones? Yeah, well, Tom Cruise did that.
Yeah, Tom Cruise did a really
nice. Who did he play? Himself or something?
I forget. No, I can't. I'm sorry. I can't remember.
Yeah, I would say, do you have any favorite,
he did something great, though.
Favorite moments in that sketch?
No, I mean, you know, something. I never watched SNL episodes, but recently I was with someone who, like, forced me, like, you gotta look at this.
Uh-huh.
And I watched the Connery things, and I was like, you know, that was pretty funny.
Oh, they're funny as hell.
Yeah. I mean, I always felt like I never did as well as I wanted to do on SNL. You know what?
Well, listen, I mean, it goes by so quick, probably. It's live, you know?
Yeah,
so.
You're like, well, if I had another hour, I could have done better to prepare, you know?
But then if you over-prepare, it could drive you nuts. You know?
But this Sean Connery was a cartoon. I mean, it's the first time I ever, like, italicized something.
Yeah.
You know, usually I just try to do it accurately, but with this one, it was like, wow, it makes more sense to, you know, more not a cartoon, but to italicize it.
Right, just make it so like a big character. Like,
yeah.
Well, no, but those all worked perfectly. What, did you have a favorite thing you did there?
No, I mean, no. I didn't think.
A favorite impression, a go-to thing you liked doing, one particular sketch that you can remember that you liked? I mean, or.
I liked doing when John Goodman played Moses.
Yeah.
I liked that one, was maybe my favorite.
And what did you do with that?
I was Clinton. I was one of the disciples. You know, I was one of the followers, Moses' followers, just like peppering questions at him. Let me just ask you, because he was talking about the Ten Commandments.
Right, like, right, right.
Let me just say that, you know. And
well, at the Clinton impression, the audience began, as a comic, this is when you're in comedy heaven. The audience began to laugh hysterically within a half a second of your bit when you just went, bite your lip.
Like, yeah.
And that was it.
Well, actually, what I did
was... You had them.
I did like that, which I never saw him do them both at the same time. Right. But I was on stage at the Cellar once, and I went like that, and the place went nuts.
Right.
And I was like, wow, that's...
As a comedian, that's comedy, everyone. In the first millisecond of your bit, you can do something physical. You haven't said something yet, and you have...
And I told you about that night I was in the crack house, right? Oh, you don't know the crack house story?
Well, it starts out great so far. Go ahead.
Oh, that was my absinthe night.
Oh, you drank that stuff?
Yeah.
I drank that in London.
Yes.
And, my God.
I so regret it.
Yeah, it was crazy. Yeah. I kind of enjoyed it. But
really?
I don't know if I did.
I enjoyed it in the beginning, but then, you know, later when...
Where did you get a hold of that?
Someone had brought it here.
Yeah.
From another city.
So did you have a hallucinatory experience from that?
I had the feeling of immense power and curiosity.
Yeah. Well, that's good.
That's good.
That's fantastic.
When some guy comes up to me.
And not in a crack house.
He's like, ask me if I want to hit the pipe. I'm like, yeah.
That's when whatever. That's when curiosity.
Like whatever
bad.
The hell it is.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah. That's what.
But I remember he said to me that he would buy the crack and pay for it. No, wait. He would buy the crack if I would pay for it.
Right.
Fine. And so, then he said he would protect me. I guess I look kind of like a cop under, you know, this.
That's Buscetti's line. He tells girls he'll protect them.
Yes, he does.
So anyway, he thought you were a cop?
No, I look like a cop. So he takes me to this crack house, and we're there doing. And this guy, the
perfect place to look like a cop.
The owner of the house comes up and goes, you know, to my friend. He's like, you know, same. I don't mean to disrespect. I don't mean disrespect to you or nothing like that. But you're wrong to bring that dude in here. Because that dude right there you brought in here, is, that man is, he's police. Do you understand? He is police. And this guy Seymour's like this. He's like, he ain't police. That dude on TV. I seen his ass last night. From across the room, between,
that's the worst, getting recognized.
Between puffs off a crack, between puffs off a crack pipe, yeah. a topless woman went, "That's Clinton." Yeah. The guy gives me like a fist bump. "You're welcome in my heart, man. You're the dude to play Clinton." Yeah, I seen that. That's good. I seen that from play Clinton. Man.
Well, it's better than a cop.
Yeah. I see that. Yeah, you good. You're welcome in my house.
That's hilarious. Hilarious.
Thanks for having me on, bro. I mean, I love making you laugh.
Oh, making me laugh. That's hilarious. Oh, that's so funny. But again, and I've been there before. I've been in situations like that where I've gotten recognized, and it's horrifying. It's horrifying.
What are you doing here?
Yeah.
Why would you be here on the River Styx?
I'm a drug addict.
Where people are losing their souls, right. And you're on TV, and exactly. What are you doing here? I just love it that they thought I was police, that I look like an undercover cop.
I asked the guy in London that night. I took the absinthe. I asked the guy, like, if I could hang out longer, because I thought he had stuff. And the guy said something. The guy said something like this. He said, "We're going to the edge of the Thames to take ecstasy and contemplate existence."
Great. I'm like, I'll do it.
That's kind of what he said. I
want to do that.
I was like, great.
Fantastic.
The edge of the Thames to take ecstasy and contemplate existence.
Wait, come on, man. You got to do that.
Can I hang? Am I in or what?
It's like I was going to get clean and sober, and yet now you say the Thames.
I am just the guy for this, guys. Yeah.
I will so finance this trip. The Thames River.
Listen, you fly out by the Thames.
The Thames.
Where? Great.
And did you do it?
Yeah, I hung out with him.
On the Thames?
We went, it was a place, it was a building close to the Thames.
Okay.
It wasn't the edge of the Thames.
Okay.
He made it sound like we were going to get bare feet and, you know, talk about Nietzsche.
Be like in a skiff, you know, with oars, talking about Nietzsche.
You can see the Thames from the building.
All right.
That was scary.
Fair enough.
Oh, dude. This is great. Well, listen, thank you for coming in, brother.
My pleasure.
Anytime. Always. April 10th and the 12th this weekend.
I think that's this weekend.
At Caroline's, is this weekend. And Sing Your Face Off May 31st on ABC. Check that out. Brother, I love you, man. Come back anytime.
Love you, too.
The great Daryl Hammond. Back after this.
The Artie Lang Show, weeknights on Audience, only on DirecTV.